let's begin with this, prayer. Whatever happens, whatever what is what I want. Only that, but that. Prayer. Whatever happens, whatever what is what I want. Only that, but that. Go ahead. Before the beginning, was I ever virgin? Did someone touch me before I could speak? Who had me before I knew I was an I? So that I wanted that touch again and again without knowing why or who or from whence it came. How the story started. I was driven toward desire by desire, believing that the fulfillment of that desire was an end. There was no end. Others might have looked into the future and seen a shape inside the coming years, a house, a child, a man who might be a help. I saw his back bent over what he was working on, the back of his neck, how he stood in his sneakers and wanted to eat him. How could I see another person? I mean, who he was, apart from me, apart from that. There's a reference in the Gospel of Luke to Mary, called Magdalene, from whom seven devils had been cast out. So here is a poem where Mary tries to speak of those seven devils. Anybody here have any devils? Here's what she said. Magdalene, the seven devils. The first, I was very busy. You know what I mean? The second, I was different from you. Whatever happened to you could not happen to me, not like that. The third, I worried. The fourth, envy, disguised as compassion. The fifth was that I refused to consider the quality of life of the aphid. The aphid disgusted me. But I couldn't stop thinking about it. The mosquito, too, its face. And the ant, its bifurcated body. Okay, the first was that I was so busy. The second, that I might make the wrong choice because I had decided to take that plan, that plane, that day, that flight before noon so as to arrive early. And I shouldn't have wanted that. The third was that if I walked past a certain place on the street, the house would blow up. The fourth was that I was made of guts and blood with a thin layer of skin lightly sewn over the whole thing. The fifth was that the dead seemed more alive to me than the living. The sixth, if I touched my right arm, I had to touch my left arm. And if I touched the left arm a little harder than I first touched the right, then I had to retouch the left and then touch the right again so it would be even. The seventh, I knew I was breathing the expelled breath of everything that was alive, and I couldn't stand it. I wanted a sieve, a mask, I hate this word, a cheesecloth to breathe through that would trap it, whatever was inside everyone else that entered me when I breathed in. No, that was the first one. The second was that I was so busy. I had no time. How had this happened? How had our lives gotten like this? The third was that I couldn't eat food if I really saw it, distinct, separate from me, in a bowl or on a plate. Okay, the first was that I could never get to the end of the list. The second was that the laundry was never finally done. The third was that no one knew me, although they thought they did, and that if people thought of me as little as I thought of them, then what was love? The fourth was that I didn't belong to anyone. I wouldn't allow myself to belong to anyone. The fifth was that I knew none of us could ever know what we didn't know. The sixth was that I projected onto others what I, myself, was feeling. The seventh was the way my mother, was the way she looked when she was dying, the sound she made, her mouth wrenched to the right and cupped open so as to take in as much air, the gurgling sound, so loud, we had to speak louder to hear each other over it, and that I couldn't stop hearing it years later. Grocery shopping, crossing the street, no, not the sound. It was her body's hunger, finally evident, what our mother had hidden all her life.